गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, आई ए टीचर ऑफ केमिस्ट्री ऑफ रानाघाट यूसुफ इंस्टीट्यूशन HS co-ed विल डिस्कस अबाउट सॉलिड स्टेट ऑफ केमिस्ट्री ऑफ क्लास 12। It's the first part. Here we will discuss about the definition of solids, classification of solids, characteristics of each type of solids, classification of crystals, some important terms in crystallography, three basic law of crystallography and crystallographic indices. What is solid? Solid is defined as a state of matter where the constituent units, that is atoms, molecules or ions, are bounded closely and strongly. Thus, in case of solid, the interconstituent energy is higher than that of thermal agitation. Solids are classified in major two classes, A. crystalline solids and B. amorphous or powdery solids. Now we want to give the definition of crystal. If the constituents of a solid are present as well ordered, that is, after crossing a particular distance, replicate of pattern is observed, then the solid is called crystalline solid. For example, sodium chloride, copper sulfate, pentahydrate, potassium sulfate, sugar, ions, alpha sulfur, etc. What is amorphous solid? If the constituents of solid are not well ordered, that is, after crossing a particular distance, no replication of pattern is observed, the solid is known as amorphous solid. For example, chalk, sodium sulfide, ferrous sulfide, amorphous sodium carbonate, etc. Now we discuss about the characteristics of crystals. Firstly, they have well-defined geometrical shape. Secondly, they have a fixed melting point as well as fixed value of latent heat. Thirdly, they are rigid and incompatible. Fourthly, they are anisotropic, that is, having a physical properties such as electrical resistance, heat capacity, refractive index and so on, which has a different value when measured in different directions. Now we have to discuss about the characteristics of amorphous solid. Firstly, they are not well defined as well as geometrically shaped. Secondly, they have no sharp melting point. They melt in a limit. Thirdly, they are isotropic. That is, all the physical properties are same in every direction. Fourthly, they are rigid but moderate. Fifthly, now the scientists are considered amorphous solids as super cold liquid because they have a number of properties similar with liquid. Now we classify the crystals. One by one we will discuss the types with examples. Number one, molecular crystals. They are again subdivided into three classes, namely hydrogen bonded crystals, polar crystals and nonpolar crystals. Hydrogen bonded crystals are the crystals which constituents of the crystals are bounded by hydrogen bond. For example, ice, solid HF, solid NH3, etc. In case of polar crystals, the constituents of the crystals are polar. As a result, they are attracted by dipole-dipole attraction, polar crystals. For example, solid carbon dioxide, solid sulfur dioxide, etc. Non-polar crystals. Its constituents are non-polar molecules. Here the attraction force between the constituents is London force. Example of such crystals are solid xenon, solid hydrogen, solid methane, etc. Number 2. Ionic crystals. Its constituents are ions. Hence, here the attraction forces are Coulombic force. For example, sodium chloride, potassium sulfate, calcium oxide, cesium fluoride, etc. Covalent crystals. Its constituents are bounded by covalent bonds. Example of such crystals are graphite, silicon carbide, boron nitride, etc. Metallic crystals. Constituents of these crystals are metal atoms and they are bounded by metallic bond. For example, metallic sodium, metallic iron, metallic magnesium, etc. and different metal hybrids. Now we have to discuss some important terms in crystallography. Faces. The external surfaces of a crystal are bounded by some planes. These planes are known as the faces of the crystal. In the picture, O, A, E, C, B, D, G, F is a typical crystal. Here the faces are AOBD, AOCE, BOCF, ADGE, BDGF and CEGF. Edges. The connection of two faces of a crystal is known as one edge of the crystal. In the picture, OAECBDGF is a typical crystal. Here the edges are OA, OB, OC, AE, AD, BD, BF, CE, CF, ZD, ZF and ZE. Interfacial angles. The angles formed by two or more faces of a crystal are known as interfacial angles. These angles are measured by goniometer. In the picture, an interfacial angle is shown. Intercepts of a crystal. An arbitrary point in a crystal can be considered as origin. Now three imaginary lines may or may not be perpendicular are considered as three axes. A surface can cut the three axes on three points. The distances from origin of such points are known as intercepts of the crystal. If the surface is parallel with one or more axes or axes, the surface is considered as cut the axis or axes at infinite distance. The intercepts are denoted by A, B and C. The considered axes are known as crystallographer's axes and the angles between two axes are known as interaxial angle. The interaxial angles are denoted by alpha, beta and gamma. In the figure, OA, OB and OC are three intercepts. Lattice points. The imaginary points which define the structural unit of a crystal are known as lattice points of the lattice. The lattice points may be the center of gravity of the constituent atoms, molecules, ions or radicals. Even lattice points may be none of them also. Now we have to classify the space lattices. On the basis of dimension, the space lattices can be subdivided into three classes. The classes are namely 1, one dimensional space lattices to two dimensional space lattices and three dimensional space lattices. One dimensional space lattices. The simplest lattice arrangement is one dimensional lattice. Here, in one direction, equidistant lattice points are spread out. These lattices may be two types, number one linear and number two zigzag. In the figure, both linear and zigzag lattices are shown. Here, only one crystallography axis is present, which is represented as A. Let the unit lattice vector is A bar and lattice vector is T arrow. Then we may write T arrow equals to H A bar, where H denotes the index through A axis. Two-dimensional space lattices. In two-dimensional lattice, the lattice points are spread out through two-dimensional spaces. Here two axes, namely A and B, are present. If the unit lattice vector are A bar and B bar through the axes A and B respectively, then we may write lattice vector T arrow equals to H A bar plus K B bar, where H and K are indices through axes A and B. In the figure, a two-dimensional lattice is shown. Three-dimensional space lattices. In three-dimensional lattice, the lattice points are spread out through three-dimensional spaces. Here, three axes, namely A, B, and C, are present. If the unit lattice vectors are A bar, B bar, and C bar through the axes A, B, and C respectively, then we may write the lattice vector T arrow equals to H A bar plus K B bar plus L C bar, where H, K, and L are indices through the axes A, B, and C respectively. In the picture, a typical three-dimensional lattice is shown. Now we discuss about three basic laws of crystallography. First law is known as Steno's law of constancy of interfacial angle. The statement of the law is, under constant temperature, the angles between two corresponding faces of a particular crystal are always constant. However it is formed, always the interfacial angles have same value. In the following figure, Steno's law is shown. According to the law, angle ABC is equal with angle A dash, B dash, C dash. Second law is known as Howell's law of rational indices or intercepts. The statement of the law is, each crystal contains three particular axes and the ratio of the inverse of the intercepts of any natural surface cut by three axes are three small integers. In the picture, Howell's law is shown. In the figure, let us consider capital A B C be a natural face and small a b c are three axes. The face cuts three axes at capital A, capital B, and capital C respectively. If unit vectors through small a, b, and c are small a bar, small b bar, and small c bar respectively, then according to Howell's law, OA is to OB is to OC equals to HA bar is to KB bar is to LC bar, or in ideal form, O1 by OA is to 1 by OB is to 1 by OC equals to KL is to HL is to HK, where HL, KL and HK are three small whole numbers. Third law is known as law of constancy of symmetry. The statement of the law is that each crystal must contain minimal number of symmetric elements which indicate the properties of the crystal. Now we have to clear the concept about crystallographic indices. The ratio of the distance cutting by any face of a crystal from the crystallographic axis and the unit vector through the axis is known as the index through the axis. The indices are whole number. In crystallography, two types of indices are used, namely Weiss indices and Millard's indices. Weiss indices. Let us suppose three axes of a crystals are small a, small b and small c respectively. The unit vectors through three axes are small a, small b and small c respectively. Again, let a face cuts the three axes at the distances h eva, k viva and l siva respectively. Thus, with respect to unit vectors, the ratio of the distance are h is to k is to l. Conveniently, it is written as hkl. If a face is parallel with one or more than one axis or axis, then it considered that the face is parallel with these axis. For example, if a face cuts the axis A at a distance P and parallel with B and C, then it is written as P infinite infinite. Weiss indices are shown in the figure. Conveniently, these are given as HKL. Millard's indices. In case of direct intercepts, Millard took the inverse of the intercepts. Let us consider a face cuts the three axes small a, small b and small c along the distances h, k and l respectively. Also, let the unit vectors through small a, small b and small c are a bar, b bar and c bar respectively. Thus, with respect to unit vectors, the ratio of intercepts are h is to k is to l. Thus, the ratio of inverse of the intercepts is 1 by h is to 1 by k is to 1 by l, or kl is to hl is to hk. This ratio is known as Miller indices. If one or more axes are parallel with the face, these or these is or are given as zero rather than infinite. In the figures, some faces are shown in accordance with Millard's indices. Reversibly, when we want to know the intercepts from Millard's indices, we first take the inverse of them. These inverse are the actual values of intercepts. Let us consider a face has the Miller indices 3, 2, 1. The LCM of 3, 2 and 1 is 6. The ratio of original indices are 3 by 6 is to 2 by 6 is to 1 by 6 or 1 by 2 is to 1 by 3 is to 1 by 6. Thus, the intercepts are 2, 3 and 6 respectively. It's also remembered that Miller indices are used internationally. The first part of solid state is finished here. If you like my video, please leave a like. If you want to follow me, please subscribe and press the bell icon. you can leave any question on the subject matter through comment. Thank you very much for watching my video.